family, friends, and guests. Welcome to Stir the Gift Home Edition 2020. My name is Renan Mitchell, and by the grace of God, I am the founder of Stir the Gift Ministry, and as well, I will be your host for this ministry, this virtual ministry gathering. I am so excited and so glad and so blessed to have you here. And I know that we're not physically together. I'm at home. You may be at home or at work or at school, at the store, at the gym, wherever you may be. But we are still together in spirit. And I'm so glad that we are together in this moment to praise and worship God, to bring His name the glory in this time. And whether this be the first time that you've heard about Stir the Gift, welcome. And I'm so glad you are here. If you've already been a part of Stir the Gift, you've attended Stir the Gift previously in previous years, welcome back. And I'm so glad that you are here. I'm looking forward to us having an amazing time in the Lord. I'm excited that and to see us all getting receive encouragement, to be blessed, to be enlightened. You know, I'm excited to see and to for us to experience hope being restored, God restoring hope back to our hearts. I'm looking forward to our spirits being revived in this time, being together in this and worshiping the Lord in this time. You know, and I just want to say that I just thank you. Thank you to all who are participating in this ministry gathering, those who have sent in and shared your videos, and that you all who are viewing right now, you will see those videos. And as we in a little bit, as we move forward in a moment, that I just want to say thank you to my brothers and sisters in Christ who have willingly and shared your gifting, the gifting and ability that God's placed within you, the ministry He's placed within you. Thank you for sharing those through video with us. So we're looking forward to being blessed by God through each and every one of you. And to all who are viewing right now, I just want to say, please, you know, I want to ask you guys to please keep your eyes and your ears open to what God will show you, what God will reveal to you, what God will speak to you through the sharing of each and every gift and ministry that you will see here, you know, and in that, you know, I just wanted to just say that Stir the Gift, you know, is all about being reminded that there is a gift, an ability that God has placed within each and every one of us, and for us to recognize that and take it very seriously and to see the value and the gifts and abilities that He's placed within us, and to make sure that we are tending to those gifts, that we're giving our time and our energy to remaining active in those gifts and abilities, and not allowing the devil to slow us down, not allowing the temptations in life to slow us down, not allowing what's going on in the world, or not allowing what's going on in our personal lives to hinder us from walking in the fulfillment of those gifts and abilities that God's given us solely for the purpose of giving His name the glory, and for lives to be touched, whether believer or unbeliever, to be touched through, for the unbelieving life or the believing life, to be touched and be reminded of who God is through us. So, you know, and also, you know, Stir the Gift is to remind us of that. Hey, it's not just about the gift. It's not focusing on the gift of the person, but it's also just focusing on the giver of the gift, the Lord God Almighty, who has placed those gifts within us. We got to remember who gave us the gift and give Him and remember that we got to give those gifts back to Him and sharing them and ministering them and releasing them and not keeping them within ourselves and not keeping them and sitting on them, you know, remaining complacent in the places of neglecting the gifts, you know, that God's given us. No, we know God doesn't want us to neglect those gifts. He wants us to share those gifts and abilities, you know, with those in our home, with those around us in our community, with our friends, with our church, you know, with in our businesses, however the Holy Spirit leads us to use and walk in those things, and those abilities and giftings. But He wants us to use those things. And if you've been in a place of where you haven't really fully been walking in or sharing those gifts and abilities that God's placed within you for His glory and for His name and with those around you, then this is that reminder for you to rise. It's time to rise up again. And it's time to stir that gift back up again. To continue in that gift, to continue in sharing that gift and ability with this world. You know, this world needs to see God. It needs to see needs to see the light that God has placed within you, and needs to see the glory of God. And they can see that through us if we remain open and willing vessels for God to use us through our faith in Him and our faith in His Spirit. You know, and that's what's, you know, we've already seen, and we've seen the times we've been through, we've seen the times that we're in now, that there is a need for hope. There is a need for encouragement. There is a need for this world to know who the Lord is, and that He loves them, and that He is He, that He will never leave us nor forsake us. That those reminders need to be released, and God can do that through you. God can do that through me. God can do that through us, through the giftings and abilities that He's given us. But we got to make sure that we are tending to them. We are being good stewards. We are being faithful and walking in the fulfillment of those gifts. We must not leave any gift or gifts or abilities that God's placed within us undone. Let's make sure that we're using every gift, each and every gift that God's placed within us, every ability that He's given us, use them all to and for the glory of God. Let's lay each and every one of them before the Lord willingly, freely, because He freely gave those gifts and abilities to us and placed them within us. You know, and so there's something that God wants to speak through your mouth, you know, to someone, and you know, and that is going to require, that's going to require us to be obedient in doing that. So you know, let's not block life from God flowing life through us to someone else. Let's not block encouragement that someone may need. Let's not block that. Let's stay open for God to use us to flow encouragement, to flow peace, to flow joy, to flow His love, to flow the gospel to others through us. So, you know, so that's what store the gift is. May you be reminded, as 2 Timothy 1 verse 6 says, therefore I remind you to store up the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of hands. This is that tap on your shoulder. If you've been in a place of comfortability, in a place and being too comfortable and not walking in the fullness of the giftings that God has given you, if you've been in the place of being complacent, if you've been in complacency, if you've been in a place of just being stagnant and being idle and not really, you know, you're fully aware of what God's given place within you, but you have been using it, you have been sharing it, then this is that tap on your shoulder to say, hey, it's okay. I know life happens, and I know that we have responsibilities. I know we have schedules. I know we have so much going on in our lives, and on top of that, we have so much going on in the world around us. I know we have all that going on, but God is still God, and He will always be God. He is the same. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So He is forever who He is. So may we continue to maintain giving Him, knowing that we don't have to allow those things and things in our lives and things around us to hinder us from still going forth and sharing what God has given, the gift and ability He's placed within us, and giving Him the glory in those areas of our life. That gift and ability that God's placed within you and me is an area that we can serve God in. So may we not neglect that service. May we not just do a disservice to God and His name by neglecting, by pushing it aside because of our own selfishness, because of our own I don't want to's, because I don't feel like it's, because I'm not sure of, because I don't know, I don't think I can do it. No, God is saying that I've given you my Spirit to be able to do it. God is saying I've given you all things. I've given you the strength. I've given you the abilities to do it, to walk in that ministry, to walk in that gift and the ability. God is saying He's given us all that we need to do it, but we got to have our faith. Got to keep our faith in Him, and we got to keep relying on His Spirit, the Holy Spirit within us, that God has placed within us to be able to fully walk in those giftings and abilities in the fullness of it, so that lives can be blessed, lives can be touched for the Lord. And that way, for His name to be glorified in and through it. So, and with the thought of Home Edition, you know, you're going to be seeing those who are ministering and sharing the gifts and abilities with us that God's given them, the videos that you'll be seeing, you're going to be seeing them share it from their office, from their home, from their church, from their vacation location, and they're from various places. And with the thought of and the awareness of that, we don't have to wait for a certain building or a certain pulpit or a certain location. We don't have to wait for a certain platform to stir up the gift. We don't have to wait for it or to share our gifts and abilities. We don't have to wait for those moments. We can share those gifts and abilities that God's placed within us, in our home, with our families, with our spouses, with our children. We can use those and minister to them. We can use it. We can stir up the gift amongst our friends. We can stir up the gift in our workplaces. And, you know, as the Holy Spirit leads and guides you, you know, we can stir up those gifts in the community. We can stir up those gifts and share those gifts and abilities in any moment. You know, ministry does not need a platform, does not need a building. The ministry of the Lord and the sharing of the giftings and abilities of that God has placed within us does not require a building or a pulpit or a stage or this or that. You know, that's the thing. You know, it doesn't need that. All God needs from us is he just looking for us to be for an obedient heart, a willing heart, a pure heart that just wants to see his name get the glory, that wants to see lives be touched, lives changed for the Lord. That's all God needs from us. So may we choose that. May we choose to be open and be fully submitted to God's purpose of why he gave us the gifts and abilities that he's placed within us. Amen. And most importantly, outside of the gifts that God's giving you, the abilities he's giving you, may you be reminded even in this that you must maintain your relationship with the Lord, maintain your walk with the Lord, maintain your walk in his presence. You know, stay in his presence, stay with the Lord, you know, because that's the thing. It's easy to be like, man, I have these gifts, I have these abilities, and it's easy to lose sight of God and that he gave them to you. And not even just that, but it's easy to lose sight of God. No, we have to make sure that we're constantly staying in God's presence, staying connected to him, because if we lose our connectivity with him, we will never be fully effective in ministering those gifts and abilities. We'll lose effectiveness in sharing the giftings and abilities and with those around us, with the community, with the world. So when let's stay in all that and in the stirring of the gifts. We cannot stir the gifts without the Lord. We need the Lord in everything, involved in every part of our lives. So may you be reminded of that. May you be encouraged in this time as we gather together to worship the Lord in through song, through spoken word, through dance, through word of encouragements, you know, through words of encouragement. And that's the thing, the gifts of ministries that you see here today is not just limited to that. You may not have that gift or ability that you see here. It's not limited to just that. There are various gifts that God has distributed and given. And it says that in 1 Corinthians 12, I encourage you to read it. There is diversities in gifts. So that means we're not all going to have the same gift and ability, but God has given us each and every one of us a gift and ability. So you don't have to look at these gifts and abilities here and say like, man, well, I don't do that. So do I really have, no, you seek the Lord and on what the gift and ability he's giving you, and you walk in the gift and ability that he's giving you. And we don't have to compare gifts and abilities with each other. No, they all came. We have to realize that it's of the same Spirit, the Spirit of the Lord. So there's no comparison needed. But God has given these gifts and abilities in his diversities, but to all be used together for the one purpose of giving his name the glory and to edify the body of Christ and to bring us all into the mindset of one faith in him. You know, please be encouraged. You know, just know that it's not limited to just these gifts and abilities. So please tap into, you know, what God has given you and placed within you and work at it. Practice. Let's make time and give effort. Give effort into give time, our time and energy and effort into cultivating and walking in and working at what God, the gift, the ability that God has placed within us for Him, not for us, not for our name to be known, not for us to gain fame, not for us to gain followers or likes or comments or shares, you know, no, just for His name alone to get the praise and glory, and so that lives can be changed and live, people can receive hope again. People can know that they can still live in the midst of a dark world, in the midst of so much going on, in the midst of uncertainties, in the midst of ups and downs. People can know that, hey, you can still live because the life of God, because God loves you, because God is with you, because God is for you. You know, that's the thing. So let's be encouraged in that. Continue to stir up the gift that God has placed within you. And if you're not sure of what God has placed, the gift or ability that God, the ability that God has placed within you, seek the Lord on and ask Him plainly, what is God, what is it that you want me to do? Or if you have a gift, God, what do you want me to do with this gift or ability for you, for your service, for your kingdom, for your glory? And He will reveal it to you. He is faithful to do so. He is faithful to speak to us. So in that, you know, I just wanted to say that. And also, I just wanted to add, you know, I know we all have roles that we have to, and responsibilities we have. We all are responsible to be moms, to be dads, to be grandparents, grandmother, you know, grandparents and aunts, uncles, and, you know, coworkers and employees and bosses and CEOs. We all have responsibilities of being teachers and doing all these things in life. And we are to tend to those things. And to be, yes, be responsible in those things, but in the midst of that, let's intertwine sowing time into the giftings and abilities that God has given us in the midst of all the responsibilities that we have, in the midst of all the schedules that we have, and the hobbies that we want to do and partake in, the places we want to go. Let's not neglect the gift that God has placed within us for Him to get the glory from that area of our lives. Because there's something that God wants to do and release through your life in that area. Amen. So without further ado, I'm ready to dive in. I'm ready to just enjoy and let's have a great time in the Lord. We're going to get started with praise and worship. And praise and worship will be led by my brother Cameron, who is also the worship leader of our church, Move Church. And he's going to be leading us in praise and worship. And I invite you to, right wherever you're at, if you're at home, at school, you know, wherever you're at, you know, if you're able to, please create a space to make and make a way for you, make a space for you to be able to just praise and worship God right where you're at, as Cameron leads us. So without further ado, let's give God praise as we enter into praise and worship, and we are led by my brother Cameron.
Hey, share the gift. I want to share a couple of songs with you today. As we get started, I want to read this verse from Psalm 96. And it says this. It says, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. It says, sing to the Lord, praise His name, proclaim His salvation day after day. Declare His glory among the nations, His marvelous deeds among all people. Then it says, for great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods. So today, wherever you are, whatever's going on in your life, I'm praying that you worship the Lord, that you sing to the Lord a new song, that you proclaim in all the earth of His glory. We're going to sing this song. It's called All the Earth. And then we're going to sing another song called The Goodness of God. And I pray that you'll worship along with me as we do this. Thank you. God, who is thy God, God? Every sky is filled with wonder. All creation lifts higher. You're the King who reigns forever. Who is thy God, God? Who is thy God, God? About the goodness of God today, what he's done for us. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. In all my days I've been held. Moment that I wake up till I lay my head, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. In all my days I've been held in your hand. I lay my head, I will see of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am I will see of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, the darkest night. You are close like no other. I know you as a father. I've known you as a friend. I have been in the goodness of God all my life. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, I will see of the goodness of God all my life. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so good. And every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, you're always running after us, Jesus. You're always running after me, yeah. Oh, you're always running after us. This is running out, it's running out to me. Your goodness is running out, it's running out to me. With my life laid down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running out, it's running out to me. Your goodness is running out. So good. I pray that you think about all the things that he's done in our life, and that you can sing that all my life you've been faithful, Lord. And that every breath that we have, we can give to him in worship.
Hallelujah. hallelujah. Let's continue to give God praise. Let's continue to give him glory. Let's continue to worship him. Just because the music has stopped doesn't mean that we have to stop our stop praising him. It doesn't mean we have to stop worshiping him. Hallelujah. Let's continue to bless his name. Let's continue to exalt his name. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are great, and you are greatly to be praised. God, we are so delighted that you have blessed us with another opportunity to praise and worship you right where we're at, oh God. God, we thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness in our lives, that we acknowledge that you have been faithful throughout our entire lives, and that you will always remain faithful throughout the rest of our life, oh God, because that's who you are. You are faithful. God, we praise you and we declare to you that great is your faithfulness. God, we thank you for your goodness and mercy that you have allowed to follow us and to continue to follow us for all the days of our lives. God, we bless you. We praise you for allowing us to taste and see that you are good. Oh God, for you are good. We bless you, God. It is such an honor, oh God, to be able to praise you and to worship you. And God, I ask you that you will help us to continue to stay in a place of praising and worshiping you. May we never leave this place of praising and worshiping you, no matter what we go through, no matter what goes on around us, no matter what goes on in our life, in our lives. May we please keep our hearts and minds in a place of always reserving praise and worship for you at any given moment, at any given time, because you are worthy of it. You are worthy to be praised. God, we bless you. God, we thank you. You are so worthy. You are so worthy, oh God. We bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh my goodness. God is so worthy. God, you are so worthy. God, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Cameron, I just want to say thank you so much for leading us in praise and worship. I appreciate you, my brother, for allowing God to use you in sharing the gift of song, praise and worship and music that he has placed within you. My brother, I pray God continue to bless and keep you as he continues to use you in leading others in praising and worshiping God. I ask you, brother, to continue to remain diligent in stirring that gift and the many gifts that God has placed within you, to continue to stir those gifts up, my brother. Now, we're going to continue to move forward as we welcome Implicit Mime. They will be coming forth and releasing a mime and praise dance and reminding us and encouraging us through this song that better days are coming. Let's give God praise as we welcome Implicit Mime. Be blessed through this ministry.
Implicit Mind Ministry would like to encourage you in these times of uncertainty. We know that some are worried right now about their finances, about their health, and about their family. We challenge you right now to find peace by standing on God's promises. He promised to never leave you or forsake you. Just hang on in there and know that better days are coming.
If you're in this
Thank you so much, ladies of Implicit Mind, for encouraging us, reminding us that we can still have the perspective of, even in the midst of being in the times that we're living in right now and what we're enduring and experiencing in our personal lives and the lives around us and what's around us, that we can still maintain and keep the perspective of better days coming. You know, and that's the thing, sometimes we experience things in life and even are currently experiencing things in life right now to where it seems like everything's dark. It seems like things are toppling on each other. Situation after situation is happening in our lives, and it makes it hard, it makes it difficult to be able to see any good coming your way. It makes it difficult to see that you're going to be able to have that you have tomorrow to look forward to, that you have something to look forward to the next week or the following week or the months to come or the years to come. You know, looking future-wise, sometimes where you're at, you know, and what you're going through in the moment makes it difficult to see you having a brighter future. It makes it difficult to see that your future will be, things will be better for you in your future as you move forward in life. And it makes it difficult to move forward when you can't see better, you know. And that's the thing, and that's honestly where walking by faith and not by sight comes into play, is that even when we can't see better, we have to trust and believe the God who is with us and walking with us, that as long as we have him with us, that we're going to be able to see better. We have to believe in him that he's going to walk us to better and carry us to better, because he's always going to lead us to the way of life, to the way of everlasting, and the way of everlasting life. And life is what he desires for us. So sticking with him, staying with him, as you ladies were, as the song that you ladies administered, as it was saying, you know, keep hanging on to the Lord. Stay with God is what I kept hearing when I was seeing you ladies minister, is that to stay with God and you'll be able to, we'll be able to make it to the better days. We'll be able to see good days as long as we continue to stay with the Lord and abide in him and stay close to him in whatever time we find ourselves in, you know. And that's why I said, you guys, you ladies, you were such a blessing. And I know everyone that's watching, I pray and I believe that they've been a blessing to you as well. So thank you, ladies, again for your obedience and your willingness to, and your obedience to the Lord and ministering this song. And again, it was so timely, and I really believe we all needed to hear that encouragement. We need to hear that life, we need to hear words of life, that, you know, that man, there is in a sense of there is light at the end of the other tunnel, because sometimes it's hard to see that light. So thank you for reminding us, ladies, that better is coming, better is on the way. So I hope that you all are encouraged. If you're in that place where it's been difficult to see better, it's been difficult to see good happening to you, that just know that you got to keep trusting and believing in God and keep walking with him and maintain your relationship with him. And allow him to unfold those better days. Allow him to fold those better moments. Allow him to work out the good for you as you continue to give him glory. Amen. So thank you again, ladies. God bless you. God bless you. Implicit Mind. God keep you guys. You guys continue to stir that gift of mind, praise, dance, ministry, and whatever other ministries and giftings that God has placed within inside of you. Whatever other giftings that God has placed inside of you, women of God, I just pray you continue to stir those gifts, ladies. I love you guys. Thank you so much. So now we're going to continue to move forward. And next up, we have Minister Jacorian, who is coming forth. He's bringing forth a word from the Lord to encourage us. And I really believe and know, and we all know, that and not even just in these times, and even if we're not going through any tough times, we still need to be encouraged. Even in the good moments and even the challenging moments, we always need to hear a word from the Lord, and we always need encouragement. So I pray that you will open your hearts and minds to hear what the Lord is saying as we welcome, and let's give God praise as we welcome Minister Jacorian with the word of encouragement.
Hey everyone, my name is Minister Jacorian Collier. I'm so honored to be a part of this Third the Gift ministry project that my brother is putting together. God is definitely doing some stirring. He's definitely doing some shaking. Everything that we perceive to be normal is getting turned upside down. And I'm just excited to see what God is going to continue to do, even in the midst of everything that's going on, everything that we're facing in the world today. So I did want to take this time to share a quick word of encouragement. The Bible tells us that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So the word I would like to share with you today is found in Isaiah chapter 43, verse 18, and then I will read part of verse 19. And the word of God reads, "Do not remember the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing." I don't know how many people I've talked to, how many social media posts that I've seen of people just saying, "Man, I just can't wait to things get back to normal. I can't wait to things get back to the way they used to be, the before all this stuff started happening." But I'm here to have you think about this. With everything that's going on in the world, I mean, we're facing a global pandemic. We're facing social injustice that's not only rattling this nation, but the entire world is being affected by the social injustice that is going on. And I wonder if the normal as we've known in the past, if that's been disrupted so much that we can never get back to what we thought to be normal. Maybe that normal, that reality that we used to perceive no longer exists because of everything that is going on. But now that I think about it, maybe that's not such a bad thing, because maybe the normal that we've been used to is not the normal that God has intended for us. See, the Bible tells us that our thoughts are not his thoughts, our ways are not his ways. So maybe the normal that we've been so accustomed to and so used to is not what God has planned for us and for our lives. So I when you think about the word normal, right, why is it so hard for people to let go of what's normal? See, normal is what we're used to, right? It's what we're accustomed to. Like, this is what we grew up in. This is what we consider normal. And no matter what that situation may be, whether it's good, bad, or ugly, it's normal. It's what we've always known. You hear people say things like, "I don't know why we do this. It's just how we've always done it. We've always done it this way. So why would we change?" I mean, even if you think about our very nature, right, as humans, we're creatures of habit. We continue to do the same things over and over because we've developed patterns and routines. And I wonder if with everything that's going on in the world right now, that God is trying to break that, saying, "No, the normal that you've become accustomed to and used to is not what I have planned for you. I have something new and something better for you." I'll give you another example, right? When you look in the Bible at the children of Israel, even though they were coming out of Egypt into their promised land, they were slaves. They were in bondage under Pharaoh. But if you read their story, as they continued to journey through the wilderness to get to the promised land as Moses led them, every time they faced a situation of uncertainty or challenges, they wanted to revert back. Why? Because was it that the promised land was not as good as slavery? No, that wasn't the issue. It was just the fact that they were used to being in bondage. They were used to being enslaved. So their mindset was, "I don't know what's ahead in the promised land or what God prepared for us, but what I do know is what I've been accustomed to for the last 400 plus years. I've been used to doing this," and there was comfort in the midst of what they conceived to be normal. But I'm here to tell you right now to encourage you that God is doing a new thing. God is preparing a new thing for us. So it's going to be difficult because we're going to have to let go of the things that we've known in the past, the things that have been familiar with, that has been comfortable to us. We have to let that thing go so we can move forward. That's why faith is so important. It takes faith to trust in God, to trust and trust the process of going forward. That's why the wilderness is so important. A lot of people want to skip that wilderness experience, but if you read that story, God said they took them through the wilderness so they would be prepared for the promised land. So when they faced trials and tribulations, they wouldn't want to go back. And I'm here to encourage you. Listen, don't hold on to the things that you knew in the past, but instead catch on to the new that God is doing. I want you to stay blessed and continue to be encouraged.
Thank you so much, Minister Jacorian, for sharing that word of encouragement through the word of God with us. I appreciate you, my brother, and I pray that God continue to bless you and keep you. And I pray that you will continue to stir up the gift of his word that is in you. Continue to stir up the gift of exhortation that God has placed within you, my brother. Walk in the fullness of it, my brother. Thank you. Now, as we move forward, I would like to welcome More Than Conquerors. They will be coming forth and ministering a song called "Your Love is Strong." And I pray you be blessed as they minister this song. Let's give God praise as we welcome More Than Conquerors.
What's up, More Than Conquerors? This is our acoustic version of Your Love Is Strong by Corey Asbury. Start the Gift 2020. You guys enjoy. One, two. Enough to calm the storm.
you, Lord, for your love. Let's just take a moment to meditate and think on the love of God. How awesome, how precious, how amazing, how love, how strong, how faithful his love is toward us. Think about and meditate on his love for you. Sometimes we need to take time to just sit and think on his love. You know, and think about how much he's always loved us. Think about his love for us. Think about his love for you. Think about how his love, the love that he's always had for us from the foundation of the world, before we were even created, that he loved us with a love that no one else could ever give us, with a love that we would never experience from anyone or anything in this earth. That God's love is so genuine and one of a kind. And we must keep reminding ourselves of that, that there is no love like God's love. He is love. And may we never believe the lie. And if you're in that place of, if you're in the place of being unsure of God's love for you, don't believe that lie that God doesn't love you, because he does. The truth is that God loves you and he will always love you, because that's who he is. God will never deny his character, who he is. God stands by his word. He is love. The word of God says God is love. His love for you is continuous, as Psalms 30, and will always remain for you. Psalms 136 says that his love, his steadfast love, endures forever. Enduring meaning that there no matter what you may do, no matter what you don't do, no matter what you may be lacking in, no matter what you may be abundant in, no matter what you have or don't have, God loves you. His love is going to endure through all of it. His love is going to weather every storm. His love is going to endure through every circumstance that you go through every circumstance or situation we place ourselves in, through every sin we partake in. God loves us. And that's not an excuse for us to stay in sin. That's not an excuse for us to take advantage of his love or to stay in those places of sin, to stay in those mistakes, to stay in those places of shame and guilt. No, his love is for us. His love endures forever for us through all those things, for us to see how strong the power of his love in that man. When you know how it is, like when you recognize, man, that person loved me through even when I disrespected them, even when I talked back to them, even when I mistreated them, they still love me. In the natural sense, think about how what that's done to your heart when you've experienced that in your life. That man, that person loved me through A, B, C, and D, and what that did to your heart. It turned your heart in respect and love toward that person, because you realize that, man, that is. No one's ever done me that like that before. And that's what God's love, in a greater way, to God's love is the highest love and the greatest love we will ever receive. And that's why his love is enduring forever for us, is that it's to help us to help redirect our hearts back to him and serving him and wanting to be in his presence and wanting to shake off the sin and wanting to shake off the shame for him, for his love, for that love. Because I mean, like, man, God, you love me that much that even when that you forgave me of that sin, of those sins, that you cleansed me of all that unrighteousness, God, I want to experience your love and the fullness of it. That's why he's loving us through everything, is that way we can turn back to him and keep our hearts turned to him and in place with him, so that we can stay in the place of receiving the gift of eternal life from him, to be have everlasting life with him. That his desire, his love for us is that his love is toward us, that and desire for us not to perish in sins, to not perish in guilt and shame, to not perish in, you know, in the place of fear and those things in sin. So that's why, you know, because God knows that the wages of sin is death. So he's not desiring for us to die in sins. Whether that be physically, whether that be mentally, whether that be emotionally, whether that be you know, spiritually, God is saying, I love you. So please, you know, rather be, you know, if you're in a dark place, if you're in a place of sin, he's saying, I love you so much that, hey, with the outstretched arm, take my hand to come out of that place so you can experience the life in me. That's what he is. That's what his love is saying. Because I don't want you to be go down that road. That's what God's love is saying. And when as more than conquerors, as you guys were sharing that song and ministering that song, I just begin to think about how much God loves me and the countless times that he showed him his mercy toward me when and that I'm here now speaking with you guys because of his love. That the many I begin to think on, man, when I put myself in many dark places, when I put myself in, got involved in so many different various sins, I could have died in those sins. I would not be here right now if it wasn't for the love of God. I begin to think on those things as you guys, men more than conquerors, as you young men of God, as you begin to share that song that his love is strong, man. God, like, who would love me knowing the things that I've done, knowing the things that I've partook in my life, knowing the thoughts that I've thought? Who would truly love me if they knew what I was thinking? Only God. And love me and still pick me back up when I felt like giving up. The times when I felt like letting go of my life, God picked me back up and spoke words of life to me and value into me that of how my reminding me how valuable I am to him, that I have a purpose, reminding me of my purpose here. That's the love of God. That's what I begin to think on, that man, God, you kept me when I had no one else. You kept me when I felt like throwing in the towel, for real, throwing in the towel of life, when I felt like when I was so full of shame and guilt because of the things that I've done, you still saw me as full of worth. You still saw me as your child, and that you didn't want me to stay in that place. And he pulled me out of those places because of his love for me, because he didn't want me to go down that road and stay in that place. And, you know, because he sees the purpose of my life, and because he sees the destiny in my life, he pulled me out of that place and gave me another chance to live for him. That's why he loves us. And may we respond in love toward him, and the love that God has for us. May we respond in love toward him. As Jesus said, the greatest commandment is to love God with all our hearts, mind, body, soul, and spirit. And underneath that, another commandment, to love our neighbor as ourself. So may we respond to the love that God has for us, the love that he's always had for us, the love that will endure forever with us. May we choose to respond in loving him with all of our hearts, our minds, our bodies, souls, and spirits, through our decisions, through the choices we make, through the way we live our lives. May we respond back in giving our life fully in love toward God. And may we respond also to the love of God for us by loving each other, by loving everyone around us, by loving everyone that we encounter. And may we choose to embrace the love of God, the love, the strong love that he has for us, the strong love that he has for you. I pray that may you make the choice to receive it, embrace it, know that he loves you, and stay in that knowing, because that knowing is going to be strength for you to carry you through everything that you go through. Knowing that his love endures forever with you is going to give you endurance to endure through everything everything you experience in life, ups and downs, losses and wins, through trials and tribulations and anxieties, moments of happiness, moments of joy, through everything. Resting in the love of God will help us and carry us through it all, knowing the simple truth that he loves us and that his love is always for us. So please don't stay in that place of guilt or shame, know that God loves you so much that he's giving you the gift of repentance to find your way back to him, back to his presence. to make the choice. He says, I love you. So repent. Turn from that thing. Turn from that sin. Turn from your wicked ways. And so that way you can receive the forgiveness that God has for you. There's freedom in the forgiveness of the Lord. There's love in that he has for you through forgiveness of our sins. So that way he can cleanse us of all the unrighteousness. And we can walk fully with him and walk in the eternal life to receive the eternal life that he has for us with him. So know, be reminded as More Than Conquerors reminded us, his love is strong for you. His love is strong for you. He always will love you. He loves us so much that he says he left us with the promise that he would never leave us nor forsake us. That even when those who say and claim that they love us walk away from us and leave us without even a word, or leave us and because of they can't deal with us, or because of whatever reason, rather it be an offense and they just leave our lives, you know, and whether it be close family or friends and things or people, friends or you know, acquaintances, whoever it is, many people have left your life, but God is saying, yes, they left, but I'm here with you, and I'm still here with you, and I will always be with you. That is the greatest love you will ever receive. So may you receive the love of God today. If you're already in the knowing, stay in the knowing of God's love for you. Rest in the strength of the love of God for you. God reminds me of one scripture, Romans 5, verses 8, that says, but God demonstrates his own love toward us, and that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. You know, even when we have moments of not even thinking about God, when we live like we forgot about him, when we have moments of not believing in him, we have moments of losing our faith in him. We have moments of, there's a scripture that says he is faithful. He is faithful even when we're faithless. That's the love of God. He is still faithful and true, even when we're not faithful and true to him. That's the love of God. That is the genuinest love. If genuineness is a word, that is the most genuine love that you will ever receive. So please know that God loves you today and every day and for the rest of your life until the day that he returns. And even when he returns to receive us up in glory, we're going to be in his love forever, man. That's why I was like, I know this is, I'm a little long in this, but I just had to just take a moment to have us soak in the love of God, because many times we forget about how much he loves us. And when we truly think about and take time to think about how much God loves us, that will help us conquer and help us walk more as conquerors in the situations that we face in life. Knowing the simple truth that, man, God loves me. No matter what people say about me, no matter what people think about me, no matter what people have said about me, it's not going to matter, because, man, God loves me with the greatest love. You don't, even if someone doesn't love you the way that they should, God's love is unfailing. God's love never fails for you. God's love for you endures all things. He believes all things. You know, man, that's the love of God. So his love is strong for you. He's reaching with the outstretched arm to you today and every day, saying, I love you. Please choose me, is what he is saying. Choose him in every day. Choose to love him. Choose to love each other. My God, thank you so much, More Than Conquerors, for sharing the gift of song, praise, and worship with us. Young men of God, you guys continue to stir up that gift that God has placed within you, and the any other gifts that he's placed within you. Continue to stir up those gifts, please, because they are valuable to him. They are valuable to his kingdom, and they are valuable to the body of Christ. They are valuable to this world, and they are needed for this world to come to know the Lord Jesus. So More Than Conquerors, and may you also continue to walk in the truth of the name of your name, the name of your group, More Than Conquerors. Know, young men of God, that you are, each and every one of you are more than conquerors. You can conquer. You can conquer any and everything that you face in life through Jesus Christ. I love you guys, man. Thank you so much again. Now we're going to continue to move forward. Next we have my friend and brother, and as well as he is one of the pastors of my church, the church that I attend, Move Church. His name is Pastor Jonathan Fox, and I am honored to be able to introduce him And he's going to be bringing a word of encouragement through the word of God. How many of us know that there is no greater way, no greater encouragement we can ever receive than through the word of God, through the life of the word of God. So without further ado, let's give God praise as we welcome with the word of encouragement, Pastor Jonathan Fox. Be blessed.
Hey there, Stir the Gift. My name is Jonathan Fox. I am one of the pastors at Move Church. And I wanted to encourage you out of Psalm 42:5. The psalmist writes, "Why are you so downcast, my soul? Hope in God." At least this has been my thought since March, when our society here in America and across the world were locked down and quarantine became normal phrases. Pandemic and isolation became part of the norm. And I think what the last few months has taught me is how much I put hope in things outside of God. And I assume those things will be there from day to day. I assume my health will be here tomorrow. I assume my breath will be here tomorrow. I assume that the systems and structures that I live by, whether that be in politics or in social places, will be here. And now here we are a few months down the road, and a lot of that has shown itself to just not be true. And when things like that happen, we find ourselves, if you look on news media, you look on social media, people are down. People are, in a lot of ways, have lost hope. People are agitated. People are angry. And I feel like that what that shows me about myself and what that shows me is about us as humanity is that we're very quick to put hope in things that don't have the ability to sustain us. They don't have the ability to be foundational to our lives because they can be changed. They can be altered. They can shift. And I love what James says. He says that in God, there's no variation of change. There's no shadow of turning. You think about the idea of a shadow, a tree, it's in one spot, but that shadow changes because the sun changes where the earth is rotating, and everything in that shadow, it could be there for a second and then it could get cloudy and then it's gone. You know, it's like we live in a world where we trust in shadows, but James says that with God, there's no shadow of change. God doesn't change. He is the same. He is our certainty in uncertainty. And the point of us bringing ourselves before this certain God is not necessarily that our situations always change to reflect what we want, but that God shows himself to be what we need. And that's difficult. That's so hard, isn't it? You know, it's so hard to trust God when you look at your life and you have trusted so many other things and so many other people for what only God could do, for security, for peace, for comfort. It's amazing to me in my own life how many times I outsource my provision, how many times I outsource my comfort, my care. And I find myself as the psalmist, and I have these epiphanies where I'm like, why are you so downcast? The reason my soul would be downcast is because I've hoped in things outside of God. I've outsourced my hope. And my encouragement to you in the times that we live in is don't outsource your hope. The certainty of God stands even in the midst of a pandemic. Even if we rewind the clock 2,000 years ago, right after the death, burial, and resurrection of the Messiah and the persecution of the New Testament church, the certainty of the church has always been God. The certainty of who God is has been placed on Jesus. And if we need to know who God is, what he's done, and what he's about, we don't have to look any further than the person of Jesus Christ to bring us that certainty and that hope that we know is true. The psalmist couldn't realize it as much as he could now for us as New Testament believers, because we could say in the Old Testament, just like the psalmist, hope in God. But now through the cross, now through Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection, we don't just have to say hope in God. And hope that who God is what we imagine or have heard stories about. We actually have the person of Jesus that proves to us that God is exactly who he says he is. And we can hope in him. And I want to encourage you with that. Hope in God. More specifically, hope in Jesus.
Pastor John, I appreciate you so much for sharing that word of encouragement through the word of God with us. I thank you for your willingness and your obedience to the voice of the Lord and sharing what God placed, what he placed on your heart to share with us. May God continue to bless and keep you, my brother. And I want you to know and be encouraged to please continue to stir up that gift of teaching, that gift of exhortation, the gift of pastoralship, the gift of leadership that God has placed upon you and in you, the gift of sharing the gospel with this world. Please continue to stir up that gift within you, my brother. And don't allow anything to stop you from walking in the fullness of that, of those gifts that God's given you and placed upon your life, my brother. I appreciate you, for I am encouraged through that word that you shared to keep my hope in the Lord and to not allow it to waver, to not allow anything that's going on around me that, or anything that's going on in my life or anything that's going on in the world, to not allow those things to sway my hope in the Lord, to cause me to rethink my hope in the Lord, to cause me to change my position and having hope, my hope in the Lord, but to maintain my position, to maintain my stance and my hope in the Lord. So I thank you, my brother, for I feel strengthened and I feel like my hope in the Lord was restored, reminded and just restored in you sharing that. So thank you again, my brother. As we continue to move forward, I would like to welcome Miss Melissa Joe, who is a dear friend and sister in Christ of mine. She's going to be sharing with you all a song of the Lord. This song is so refreshing and so full of joy and rejoicing. So I ask you that wherever you're at, you know, please feel free to just praise and worship God, rather be through dance. Even if you want to dance along as she ministers this song, you can dance, you can sing, however you God leads you to praise and worship. And even as you just, however you praise and worship God, take this time, use this time to just be free. Be free in the Lord. Be free in your praise and worship to the Lord. But use this time to give him glory in this time. And let's join in with Miss Melissa Joe and praise and worship God as she leads us in this song. And without further ado, let's give God praise as we welcome Miss Melissa Joe.
Well, hello. My name is Melissa Joe, and I am one of the worshipers at His House on the Ascension team. And Renaud and Brianne were so wonderful and so lovely to invite me to worship with you all. And it's like, Lord, what would you like to deliver to the people through me? I'm a willing vessel. Amen. So, you know, just all the craziness and things that are going on around in the world, I just feel like it's time to have some joy in our life. And let's just bring in the joy with our worship, with our praise. Amen. So this song that I'm going to be doing, it's by Kim Walker Smith, Jesus Culture. It's called In the River. I'm going to be singing along with the music in the background. She's going to help me sing it because I don't want to make a mess of it. But praise the Lord. We're going to worship him. We're going to be set free, because when we are worshiping him in spirit and in truth, he inhabits our praises. And when he inhabits our praises, the presence of the Almighty King has, there's no other option than to break things off that need to be broken off. Addictions, bad relationships, you name it. He is there with us, healing us from the inside out, healing our mind, healing our heart, healing our emotions. Amen. So let's just get right into it. Hallelujah. Hey. Hallelujah. Glory. My God, you are awesome. Hey.
There is a river where goodness flows. There is a fountain that drowns sorrows. There is an ocean deeper than fear. The tide is rising, rising. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God and of heaven, crashing over us. The tide is rising, rising. Bursting up from the ground, we feel it now. Burst. washing over us. The tide is rising, rising.
Praise. He's worthy of all of our worship. He's worthy of all of our attention. Amen. Let's give God all the glory for everything that he's done for us and everything that he's kept us from. Amen. Well, I love you all so very, 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 very much. I love you with the love of the Lord. I hope that you all were blessed, that you would jump into the river and allow God to wash you clean. Amen. All right. Well, I love you all, and I hope that you have a wonderful, most blessed rest of your day. Mwah.
Thank you so much, Miss Melissa, for sharing that song with us that the Lord placed on your heart to share and for reminding us. Thank you for reminding us that no matter what times we are in currently, and no matter what times we may face ahead of us, and no matter what we go through on a daily basis, that we still can walk in those things and in those times in joy, in the joy of the Lord, and that we should choose joy because the Lord has given us access to his joy freely when we accepted him as our Lord and Savior. So we have access. He's placed his spirit within us. So we are alive in him. So we have to keep reminding ourselves of that, and we can allow the hard times, the darkness that is around us, we can't allow the wickedness that is around us to consume us or to get us boggled down, to make us or to get us into a place of bondage to where we feel like we can't move or we feel like we can't still have joy. We feel like we can't laugh. We still we can't allow those things that's happening around us to get us to the place where we feel like we can't even smile. But we have to remind ourselves that no, the joy of the Lord is my strength, and we have full access to that joy 24/7 because the Lord is with us and he's placed his spirit within us. So thank you so much, Melissa, for releasing that song. I feel so refreshed. I feel I just felt the joy of the Lord, even in the ministry, in you ministering this song. I felt the joy of the Lord, and I feel revived in my spirit, and I felt like I'm ready to keep each day, take each day by force, and claim my days back by saying that no, each day I'm going to choose joy, and I'm going to walk in joy despite of what I may feel, despite of what is going on around me. That doesn't change who God is. That doesn't change the access that I have to His joy, to His peace. So thank you so much, Miss Melissa. God bless you. God bless you and keep you, my sister in Christ. And may you continue to stir that gift of praise and worship, music, song, that the song of the Lord that He has placed within you and placed upon you. And allow Him to continue to use you in the fullness of Him. I love you, my sister. So we're going to keep moving forward. And next up, we have a brother, dear brother of mine. His name is Prince Purposed. And he's going to be coming to minister to you all a verse from one of his songs that he has written and produced. And I pray that you guys be blessed. Please take a moment to just open your heart, open your mind, your ears to hear the words that he's going to be sharing through this verse and through this part of this song that he's going to be sharing from one of the songs he's written. And without further ado, let's give God praise as we welcome my brother, Prince Purposed.
Blessings, guys. Here, I wanted to share a verse with you from a song I have called Final Hour. This is just me at the crib. It goes like this. In the last few moments of breathing, I walk down the street and then grab a random person and start repeating John 3:16 and crying and pleading. He died for you, rose for you, chosen you. Please believe him. The things you have seen, who have seen on the scene are deceiving. I was the thief on the cross, lost all with a sawed off, sparking and chief and involved with the demons with thoughts to get even. And Paul, for the reason for all the bereavement, keep all the achievement. He's offering peace, so quit harboring heathens. The martyrs are grieving, the doubt and out is a call, and we are to go reach him. We got the redeemer, we ought to redeem him. Results of the fall is not the cause of the treatment. It's deep in the soul, pause and release it. The spirit is willing, given to repent and believe. Men are diminishing. Attended with tenant and limit your sinners and decent. The descendants of him are limitless. All aboard, because I'm leaving, throw up my peace. And if I only had 1 hour to live, I'd call upon my friends, say my last goodbye. If there was just 1 hour to live, I'd probably be so old. But I know my life wasn't wasted. How would you spend your final hour? Yeah, Prince Purposed here. What's going on, guys?
Prince, my brother, I just wanted to say thank you so much and that I appreciate you for your willingness and sharing with us, man, the gift that God has placed within you, the gift of song, man, and just listening to that verse. And those words that God gave you are so powerful and truly blessed me, man. And I just wanted to say and thought of just as towards the end of the song, as you begin to share and sing, if I only had 1 hour to live, man, really helped in shaping my perspective even more on life. That, man, I need to be more appreciative. I need to be more intentional in how I live my life here on earth and how I live my life and for the Lord, man, in my walk with God and just being intentional that, man, truly, if I only had 1 hour to live, how would I spend it? You know, and it also just it taught me in that, and you sharing that verse, my brother, that I need to value life more, value my life more, value the life of those around me more, man. So I just want to say thank you so much, my brother, for being obedient to the Lord and to the voice of the Lord and sharing that with us, man. May God continue to bless you and keep you, Prince, and as you continue to go forth and ministering the gifts that he's placed within you, man, please continue to stir up those gifts, my brother. Remain active in it. Remain consistent in those gifts, walking in the fullness of those gifts, man, and don't allow anything to hinder you or to stop you, man, from walking in the giftings that God's giving you, my brother. God bless you, man. I love you. So we're going to continue to move forward, and we're about to get ready to close out, but we're not going to close out without introducing our last minister of Stir the Gift Home Edition 2020. He goes by the name of J.O. Speaks. He is a dear brother of mine and that I've known for over all many years, man, and he's been such a blessing in my life. And I just, he's going to be bringing forth to us the gift of spoken word and the name of his spoken word, the title of his spoken word that he'll be ministering to us and encouraging to us, encouraging our hearts with, is called The Cure. So may you guys be blessed, and let's give God praise as we welcome J.O. Speaks.
There's another pandemic at play. And it doesn't just affect the lungs, but it alters the heart of every soul. It waxes love cold. And the worst part about it, there's nothing in and of ourselves that can stop it. There's nothing in and of ourselves that we can do about it. Not quarantine, not good hygiene, not even social distancing. But this disease is fatal. It's extremely crippling. And the sickness has incubated the ills of social injustice, inbred systematic racism and oppression, while cultivating specimens into sexual sin. It has harvested a culture fermented in anger, lying, and gossip, and small traces of idolatry, covetousness, and pride are found with further diagnostics. And due to our codependencies of this disease called sin, our relationship with God has become toxic. And even those that are sheltered in place, they are not safe, because this disease is known to lure them away, and it operates through our own desires. So when sin has reached the end, it brings forth death. And this is an isolation that will separate God from self, take life from breath, and no respirator would be able to make you whole. God's love will break hearts in order to save souls, for he loved the world so much that he gave up his own, his one and his only. He is a great God seeking for a generation that will come before him boldly. Even though it was our sin that left us lonely, he never wanted his church separated from the state of himself. So God, he wrapped himself in flesh just to approach our sin-sick self. He removed his gloves in exchange for nailed hands. He traded in his mask for a crown of thorns. He doesn't socially distance himself by 6 feet. Instead, he takes nails in his hands and his feet. He draws us closer to his pierced side. He COVID himself in our sickness so that we could be forgiven. He who knew no sin has now become sin for our righteousness. But how? How do we carry this vaccine inside of this earthen vessel? And this is the place in which I wrestle, because the power belongs to God and not us. And even though we are afflicted in every way, we are still not crushed, because we know that it is in God that we trust. Perplexed, but we're not driven into despair, because we know that God is still there, persecuted but not forsaken, because we stand on a rock that's not easily shaken, struck down but not destroyed. Because although some trust in chariots and some trust in horses, we trust in the name of our Lord. So for the Christian, the resurrection is not the end of the story. Rather, it's only the beginning of life, the hope of glory. Because Christ has imputed immunity to this penalty of this virus called sin. He rose and left the empty tomb to show that the needle of death has even lost his sting. So, is he Lord of your life? Do you know him as King? Are you worshiping a living Savior? Have you made him your everything, or have you left your Savior on the cross? Have you left the bridegroom in the tomb? Are you trying to cover this bill, paying your own cost? If so, you are still infected. But he stands at the door and knock. Are you going to let him in, or will you reject him? He wants to be King of your life. Will you accept him? If not, this disease can easily worsen, because Easter was never about a big production, but it was only about one person. Jesus is the resurrection. Jesus is life. And no one will see the Father unless they go through Jesus Christ, because Jesus is alive. Jesus is King, and we have all been commissioned to go and spread this vaccine, to go and spread the gospel, to go and spread the good news that this resurrection not only changed death, but it also changed life. So we draw close to a living, risen Savior, because we know that the cure is simple. The cure is Christ.
Yes, it's in Jesus that we can find everything that we need, everything that we want. We find in Jesus. If you're in a place of feeling hopeless, you can find hope again in Jesus. If you're in a place of feeling depressed, you can find peace and strength in Jesus. If you're in a place of feeling anxiety, fear, worry, you can find rest from those things, peace in those things, only in Jesus. As J.O. was sharing, the cure is Christ. The cure for everything that we experience in this life is found only in Jesus. Jesus is the answer that we all have been looking for, that we all are looking for. You know, in our daily lives, we're trying to figure out what's going on in our lives. We're trying to figure out why we're going through this, why we're going through that. You know, but some of us are trying to figure out our purpose in life and all of that. Our purpose, our destiny, our future can only be found in and through Jesus Christ. So may we run to him today. If our bodies are filled with sicknesses, diseases, any kind of infirmities, and we're in need of relief and healing of those things, we can find our healing, our true healing, only in Jesus and through Jesus. Jesus has healing waiting for you today, available for you every day. Go to him. He is saying, come unto me, all ye who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for he is, as his word says in Matthew. Let me go there real quick. I want to make sure that I say this correctly and in its truth. It's in Matthew 11. And it says, this is Jesus saying to us today, take my yoke upon you and learn, take his yoke upon you and learn from him. For he is gentle and lowly in heart. Jesus is gentle and lowly in heart. So you can come to him freely. And you will find rest for your souls. For his yoke is easy. And his burden is light. So many times we yoke up to different things. We connect our lives to so many different things in this world. In our lives. That end up weighing us down. And they end up draining hope from us, that end up draining life from us, that end up draining faith from us, that end up draining courage from us, that end up draining our own sense of ourselves. We feel we end up losing ourselves and the many things or people that we've been yoked up to. But I'm here today to tell you that you can connect, you can take Jesus's yoke upon you. Connect, take off any other yokes that you've been, any things you've been connected to that has been slowing your progress down in your walk with God, anything that's been slowing you down and walking in the fullness of the gifts and abilities that God's given you. May you receive the yoke of Jesus Christ upon you, because his yoke is easy and his burden is light. We're carrying many burdens that we shouldn't be carrying that has not benefited us in any way in our lives. And Jesus is saying, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. All God is asking of us is just to be obedient to him, his will, his way. You know, and the word of God says that his commandments are not burdensome. You know, it's just in our love, when we respond in love to him, it's going to be so much more lighter in walking with him and walking and following his commandments and walking in the giftings and abilities that he's placed within you, walking in life with him, walking through life. If we can just choose to take on the yoke of Christ and also know that we can go to him and as he says in verse 28 of Matthew 11, verse 28, he says, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus is saying, come to me. If you are discouraged, come to me is what Jesus is saying to you today. If you are feeling hurt or abandoned, Jesus is reaching out to you with an outstretched arm saying, come to me. Jesus is saying, I am the answer to no matter what you may go through. There is, in the word, as the word of God says, there is nothing too hard for God. So we may have a list of things that we have experienced in life, a list of things we're going through currently in life, but none of those things are greater than God. None of those things surpass God and his greatness and his power and ability to deliver you out of those things, to deliver you out of those sins, to deliver you out of that discouragement, to deliver you out of that fear. If fear, anxiety, depression, stress, suicide, you know, whatever it is that you may be dealing with, just even just a loss of hope, you feel like you've lost your identity, your purpose, you don't know what your purpose is, Jesus is saying to you today, come to me. As he says in verse 28, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. So if you're in a place of you've been running away from Jesus, if you've been running away from his call upon your life, if you've been running away from stirring up, walking in the gifts that he's, in the abilities he's given you and stirring up those gifts, if you've been trying to hide or stay away from anything associated with the gifts and abilities that God's given you and using it for his glory, I'm asking you today right now to come back to him. Come back to the way of the Lord. Come back to the gifts. Come back to tending to the gifts and abilities that God has placed within you. There is rest in that place. There's rest in surrendering to the Lord. There is rest, so much rest and peace, and resting in and his ability, resting in his spirit, resting in. There's so much rest and peace in doing his will and choosing his will over yours. There's so much rest and peace in choosing him over the many things in this world. There's so much peace and rest when we choose to walk away from discouragement, to walk away from fear and say, man, I'm choosing faith in my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. There's rest in that, in choosing faith, and there's rest and peace in trusting in the Lord with all of our hearts, not leaning on our own understandings, but in all of our ways, acknowledging him. It says that he shall direct our path. There's direction. Direction comes to us when we choose to just come to him. Jesus is the answer. Jesus, as J.O. was sharing in that spoken word, Jesus the Christ is the cure. He is the answer that we need. He is what you need. You've been trying to figure out what you've been looking for. You've been trying to figure out why your life feels so empty, why you feel like you have this and that, but you still feel like something's missing. If you don't have Christ, you are missing him. That's who you're missing. That's what you are missing in your life. So may you receive him today. May you go run to him today. Run into his loving arms today, for he is waiting for you. He is saying, as he says in his word, Jesus said, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. I even hear God saying, even in that, sometimes we labor so much and our gift and the gift and abilities that God's gave us, it becomes labor. We labor in those things to where it just becomes, we're just functioning in it, but we're not enjoying it. When we lose our joy in it, we're allowing ourselves to lose our joy in serving God in those gifts and abilities. We've become all who labor and are heavy laden. We've labored in the gifts and abilities that God's given us. But some of us have gotten to the place where it's become redundant. We've lost the joy in doing it. We've lost serving the Lord in gladness, as his word says, through those gifts and abilities. And Christ is saying, come to me and I will give you rest in the midst of laboring for me, in the midst of that, in the midst of serving me. Jesus is saying, in the midst of serving me through your gifts and abilities, I can give you rest in those things, in doing those things, in stirring those gifts. I can give you rest so you can do those gifts and operate in those gifts and abilities in my peace, in my joy, in gladness, not being burnt out. Sometimes, you know, we labor so much in the gifts and abilities that God's given us that we end up getting burnt out. you know, in our, you know, if, whether we're serving in church, whether we're serving out in the community, whether we're serving wherever we minister the gifts and abilities that God's given us, and we use those gifts for His glory, you even get to the point of where sometimes you end up losing sight of that, man, is for His glory, is for God. We've been laboring in those gifts and abilities, but some of us have forgotten who it's for, who we're laboring for, who we're stirring up the gifts for. And it's for Christ. So that's the thing. If you've forgotten, if you've ran away from tending to those things, if you have neglected the gifts and abilities that God's placed within you and using them for His glory and using them for the edifying of the saints and using them to bring lost souls and unbelievers to Christ, then Jesus is saying, come to me so I can give you rest. And you can be with it that way. Once you get rest in those places, once you receive the rest of God, you can begin to walk, get back into stirring up those gifts and abilities, and with the soul's intent, the mind's intent of this is for God. And when you begin to do it just for God, the expectations, all the high expectations, all the things that we place on ourselves, the weights that we place on ourselves of, man, I got to do this, I got to do this. All that begins to go away when you truly begin to just keep the mindset of this is for Christ, this is for His glory, so that's why I'm doing it. When you do it for Him and just for Him and not for anything else, not for money, not for fame, not for yourself, not for you to gain followers, not for any of that, when you begin to do it just because it's for God and you recognize it's for Him because He gave you the gift and the abilities, He will do the rest. And you receive you will walk through it with rest and so much more peace, and you'll be at peace and be able to minister and be so much more effective in releasing those gifts and abilities in this earth, so that way we can all come to the knowledge of who God is and bring everyone back to those who have been away from His presence, those who don't know Him, to come into His presence, to become one in Him, one in faith in Him. So and in that, God reminds me of one more scripture as we're closing. And before I mention this scripture, I just want to say, J.O., my brother, thank you so much for sharing that spoken word and reminding us that our hope is in God, and that reminding us that everything is for Christ, everything is for Him. It's easy to forget that. We get caught up in our life and our schedules. We get caught up in our the responsibilities we have in this life. And we allow those things, we allow ourselves to allow those things to help us forget why we're here and why God sent us here. So thank you, my brother, for reminding us of that awesome spoken word of the power of Jesus Christ, that we've been commissioned to, in this earth, to minister the gospel of Jesus Christ to everyone so that way they can be drawn to Him. Thank you so much, my brother, for being diligent in sharing the gift of spoken word with us. I pray God continue to bless you and keep you, and that He continue to, that, and I pray, my brother J.O., that you continue. I ask you to please continue to stir up the gift of God of spoken word, and that whatever other gifts and abilities He's placed within you, my brother, continue to stir those things up, those gifts up, and continue to use them for His glory. Because people need to hear what God has to say through you, my brother. And so God bless you. God keep you, J.O. And I just want to close with this scripture. And it's coming from... Yes, here it is right here. Thank you, Lord. And it's coming from 1 Peter chapter 4, verses 11. And it says, if anyone speaks, let him speak as the oracles of God. If anyone ministers, let him do it as with the ability which God supplies. But be reminded of that today. In all the abilities and giftings that God's given you, do it. Make sure that it's connected to God, and that the strength for those abilities, the way to do that, let the source of your abilities and gifts always be of God and be supplied. Allow God to supply you with what you need to minister, what you need to minister and walk in those giftings and abilities. That in all things, God may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom belong the glory and the dominion forever and ever. Amen. That in all things, in everything you do, in all of the ministering of the giftings and the abilities that God's given you, that God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. That's what this is for. That's what Stir the Gift is about. That's why God has placed the gifts and abilities within you, that he may be glorified through Jesus Christ. So may you be reminded of that. And I just hope and pray that you were blessed by every minister or ministry that you saw here on this virtual ministry gathering. I hope and pray that you were encouraged. I hope that if you didn't know, if you were unsure of the gift or abilities that God's given you, that before we started this gathering, I pray that you are sure of it now. And if you're still unsure of what God, the gifts and abilities that he's placed within you to use for his glory, I pray that you will continue to, and I admonish you to seek the Lord on what those gifts and abilities are, and ask him to make it plain to you, to make it clear to you what those gifts and abilities are and what your purpose is. And he will tell you. You just ask and you shall receive, is what his word says. So ask the Lord plainly how you can serve him through the gifts and abilities that he's giving you for his glory. Because it's needed. As J.O. was saying, we have been commissioned out. The world is in need of hope. The world is in need of courage. The world is in need of faith to be restored again. The world is in need of to be reminded of that they can still have peace in the midst of all that's going on. The world is in need of that, of the life that the Lord provides. And we as his people, you know, if we're willing and able, God can use us to be that hope to someone, for him to release his peace through us to someone, through whatever gift or ability God has placed within you. Those around you need it. The world needs it. So please, you know, as the word of God says, as Jesus said, let your light shine before men, that all may see of it and glorify your Father in heaven. So continue to let your light shine, you know, and before men, you know, that all may see and glorify God. That's why you're able to speak forth hope, and you're able to share the word of encouragement, share the word of the Lord, you know, whatever the gifts and abilities God's giving you, so that way you can be able to point people back to God. So with that, and allow God to reveal the gifts and abilities he's given you, and the purpose of those gifts and abilities to you. Allow him to reveal them to you. And when he reveals them to you, go walk in it in his grace, and allow in his ability, and allow him to use you mightily. Stay willing to God, to his spirit to flow through you. Stay open to what his spirit is saying, and allow him to use you. Don't put any limits on God and what God can do in and through you. It's not about us. God can even minister through you and minister to you through you ministering to someone else. By you sharing those gifts and abilities with others, God can bless you, and God can minister and pour back into you. So with that, we're going to be closing. I just wanted to just say thank you all so much thank you so much for joining us in this Stir the Gift Home Edition 2020. I'm so glad that you joined us. And I want to say that we'll be hosting, I will be hosting another one soon. And, you know, I'll be keeping you guys posted on that. But if you are interested in being a part of the next Stir the Gift, please reach out to me through message and send me a message and just let me know. And I would love to have you be a part of what God is doing through Stir the Gift Ministry. And so that way he can, for the sole purpose, so he can get the glory from our lives. Amen. So you guys be blessed. Continue to stay well. Continue to stay healthy. Do what you can to maintain healthiness in your life. And most of all, continue to walk with God. Stay with God through every moment of your life. You know, if you fall, get back up again and keep pursuing God. Keep walking in the gifts and abilities that he's given you in his strength, by his spirit, not by your own strength, not by your own might, but by his spirit. You know, and I just want to encourage you in that. Continue to stir up the gifts. Remain active in it. If you haven't been active in it, I encourage you to get back up again and get back into using the gifts and abilities that God's placed within you for his glory, for his name, not for our names, but for his name. And watch God be blessed and glorified, and watch those around you in this world, in your home, and your life be transformed for the glory of God and be changed and be blessed. Amen. I love each and every one of you. Thank you all so much. And may you continue to be encouraged and stay blessed. And most importantly, God loves you always. God bless you. God keep you. And until the next Stir the Gift, I love you guys. Stir it up. Keep stirring. Stir it up. Stir it up. Keep stirring. Keep stirring. Keep stirring the gift. Hey, I love you guys. Be blessed.